This video is brought to you by Miniature Market. Thousands of board games, discounted prices, miniaturemarket.com.
Hello my friends, it's the Game Boy Geek here. In addition to loving board games, I love music. I'm a saxophone player, a music producer, I've been in a national traveling band, and so when I keep a game, I give it a saxophone serenade where I actually play a little doodah and serenade it into my collection. So here's the games that got those saxophone serenades, or my gaming library additions for this past month of February 2017. First is a game called Coin Quest. Now you've heard of deck building games. This is a bag building game where you're bidding on coins, you're getting those coins, they're going into your discard pile, they're getting back into your bag eventually, and you're drawing them out. Some of them are gonna give you better things to bid with, some of them are gonna give you points, some of them are gonna give you some special abilities. It's a fun little game. Next one is Castles of Caladale. This is similar to, say, a tile placement game like Carcassonne per se, but everyone is working on their own castle. And by the end, you have this interesting looking castle that just looks very different from anything I've ever seen. If you like those relaxing tiling games, it's a light game, but it's one that takes that Carcassonne idea and just makes it different, and it's really interesting. I loved it. Next one is Rocky Road a la Mode. This is a excellent 15 to 30 minute filler game where you're an ice cream truck driver. You're running that business, you're restocking ice cream, you're using a loudspeaker to get people to come, and then you are essentially giving them what they want, the nice ice cream, and you're building up sort of an engine building thing. It's got simple mechanisms, excellent artwork, it's a lot of fun. It's a different theme. Feels a little bit of Splendor-ish as well with some of the decisions you gotta make, so check that one out. Next one is called Team Play. This is a card game for teams. It's a team versus team. So it's a 4 or 6 player game essentially. And it's a very sort of a lightish partnership card game where you're trying to draw cards, finish goals that are in front of you, or maybe some public goals, but you're also passing cards to your partner, but you can't communicate. And so you're trying to figure out, okay, what does that person have? And how can I help them get their goal? It's just a really fun sort of filler style 30 minute card game. It's not very heavy, but it's got a lot to think about. Really excellent game there. And the last one was Santorini. This is a very hyped 2-player, I guess it plays 2, 3, or 4 players, abstract strategy game. It's 3-dimensional. You're building up this city of Santorini. And so it's an interesting game, but it's got these god powers that make the game, every game feels completely different. It is very abstract. So if you don't like the abstract games, you might not like this one, but you might want to try it because it is pretty amazing. It's simple, takes less than five minutes to learn, probably 30 seconds to learn really, but a lot of depth. So those are all the games I kept this month. Ooh, if I had to pick my favorite, yeesh, I don't know here. I might have to lean towards Team Play just because it's one that my wife enjoys. So we've been playing a lot with a lot of different groups, but really all of these are excellent. So those are my saxophone serenades of the month.
This video was sponsored by Miniature Market's Review Corner. The Review Corner features podcasts, video, and written game reviews by gamers for gamers. Miniature Market, the online gaming superstore. Thousands of board games, discounted prices. Check them out at miniaturemarket.com. I'd like to thank each and every one of you for backing me on Kickstarter, making this season become a reality. I'd like to especially thank those here that have backed me at the credit level. Now, these video reviews are also available by audio on our podcast. It's the intros and the final thoughts on GameBoyGeek.com. Click podcast.